Hey guys, Brittany here from Hardy Art Studio. Now today I thought I would quickly jump on and go through one little part of my workshop success playbook. All right, so if you are someone who is interested in running their very own profitable creative workshops, then I highly recommend you jump onto my website and download your free copy today. You can also click the link in my bio if you're on Instagram, or just go to my website and you'll see it on there. So get your copy, guys. It's free and it's filled to the brim of amazing workshop tips and tricks. So today I thought I would just go through the first little part with you. So I want to just go through one little part, which is coming up with the best workshop idea ever. So this is super important, guys. So before you even start making prototypes, any of that kind of thing, I want you to go through these little points. I want you to think about them. They're prompts to get you thinking. You may even want to jot these down. Like I said, download the workbook. You can print it out and put your info in here. All right. So I can remember planning my very first workshop, planning very loosely, right? I was very confident about running kids workshops, but adult workshops, I had a huge fear. I was filled to the brim with imposter syndrome. I'm one of those teachers that is terrified to speak at staff meetings because I'm worried that I'm going to sound uneducated or too laid back, that kind of thing. So I was terrified. And my very first workshop, I can remember, adult workshop, I only had two people actually sign up to come. And luckily though, my bestie, she came and brought two other friends with her. So we had five people. It was awesome. The workshop, my structure and everything was good, but my whole planning, was not very good and my marketing was not good at all either. So again, like I said, this book will give you some other tips and tricks that you can check out and it will help you to plan a successful workshop. All right, so let's get started. The best workshop idea ever. Now, I want you to think straight up, what would your audience love to create? What will capture their attention and have them keen to hit the book now button? So brainstorm your ideas below. Remember, it's just a brainstorm. Get your ideas out. There's no right or wrong here, guys. Write them below. Moving on, we've got, are there any current creative trends or products that you could draw inspiration from? So, you know, you could jump on TikTok and see what are those viral videos that everyone's obsessed with watching? Like, for instance, you know, those demolding videos of when people are like demolding their resin jewelry or creations. I personally, I'm obsessed with those like terrazzo looking what are they like, little tidy trays and things? So jump online. What are the current creative trends or products? Okay, list them here, guys. Next up, what do you love and are skilled at creating? So are you a florist who creates the most amazing like floral arches for weddings? Maybe you're a florist and you make these beautiful dried flower arrangements. That would make such a beautiful workshop. People coming to create their own little dried flower arrangement they could take home. Or maybe it's even like a wreath for your Christmas table. There's so many cool things that you could do that are just off the top of my head. So what do you love? What's your niche and what are you skilled at creating? Pop it in the box here, guys. The next one is, what questions do followers ask you about time and time again? What advice do they come to you for? Okay, another example I can think of is perhaps you're like a resin artist and you create resin jewelry that's just amazing. And heaps of your followers come to you and ask about how you make your molds or what your process is, that kind of thing. This would be another great idea for a workshop that you could look into. So like I said, guys, pop your ideas here. Another really cool idea that, you know, I think would work really well is whenever someone does ask you a question about your process, about your craft, you could actually start writing a list of these questions. Okay. This could be like your little workshop ideas board, or you could just have some notes in your phone, something like that, but write them down. Okay. I've started doing this and I have a whole list of ideas for different workshops that I'd like to do in the future. So that's a handy little tip there. Moving along. I want you to look at your business or creative social media page for a post of one of your creations that garnered a lot of comments or questions. What clues for workshop topics can you see here? So you, as a creative, you've got to have posts that stand out. I'm sure there is something that you've made or created that people just went nuts for. Could this be, the best workshop idea ever? Could this post give you some hints for a workshop topic? All right. So go back through, look at those posts that garner lots of attention and write them down here. All right. Now, lastly, what I want you to do is I want you to look at all the notes that you made above. Can you identify any patterns? Is there a topic or art form you've listed multiple times? Is there something new you'd love to create? It's time to name your three favorite workshop ideas here. So pop them below. I'd love for you guys to share them with me in the comments below. Tell me, what are your three workshop topic ideas? I'd love to hear all about them. And like I said earlier, guys, if you'd like to take a further look at all of this, and there's heaps more to come, download my Workshop Success Playbook, clicking the link in my bio. Honestly, guys, you are going to love it. I'm super proud of it. And if you have any questions at all, please feel free to DM me. I'd love to help you any way that I can. So enjoy the rest of your day, guys. Thanks for tuning in.